Welcome to the fifth laboratory session. So in the last few classes, we saw how to do a systematic dissection of a product and identify the parts and then prepare a parts list as well as the assembly chart for a product. And the technical assistants were helping you to do this task, and I hope now you are familiar how to do the first part of the dissection process, where you do in a systematic way of opening the product, identifying the parts and the sub-assemblies, and then looking at the functions of these parts. So now today we'll be looking at a different product. So this product is going to be the electric kettle and a rice cooker. So we'll be doing two products: electric rice cooker and an electric kettle. So both of them have some kind of common things. That's why we have clubbed them, these two, together. And you will be looking at these two products, doing the product dissection. At that same time, you will be practicing a theoretical concept that we learned in the class, that is how to prepare the needs list for a product. So looking at the customer requirements, how do you identify the customer needs and then prepare a list of needs based on the priority of the needs. During the theory class, we saw how to conduct a proper need identification exercise using like-dislike methods, and then doing a sorting of the needs using affinity diagram, and then finally coming to the list of needs for a product. So in this case also, we will be going for the preparation of needs list by following the procedure that we already learned of getting the needs identified. Okay, so the product that we are going to use is electric rice cooker and electric kettle, and the objectives of this exercise basically to understand the function of the product and identify all the parts and sub-assemblies and prepare the parts list and assembly chart, which is the common for all the exercises. And now in this exercise, what you will be doing different from the previous exercise is the carrying out the like-dislike method of need identification. You know how to do this need identification using like-dislike method. We have seen a few examples in the class, the theory class. So you will be having, each one of you will be having a format for the like-dislike method, and then you write down your likes and dislikes and then convert that into interpreted needs and then prepare a needs list. So each one of you will be having a set of needs, and as a group you sort out these needs using affinity diagram method and finally come up with the needs list with the priority. So that is what is expected from you as part of this exercise or the outcome of this exercise. And one of the products we will be using is the electric rice cooker. Most of you might have seen this product. It's a very simple product. There are not many complex mechanisms or systems inside. A very simple product with the electric module for heating and sensors and some switches for cutoff of the electricity based on the status of the process going on. Okay, so the product is electric rice cooker, and the primary principle is based on the fact that water contains constant temperature while boiling. So this principle the TA will explain to you. So basically, when there is water inside, the temperature will be always constant, and when the water is completely drained, then the temperature will start increasing, and when the temperature starts increasing, the system will cut off the power supply, and then it is ready for or it just cook, the rice is already cooked by then. That is the basic principle. Okay, so you will be looking at the electronics and the heating, what is happening inside the product, that you will be able to see, and the TA will explain to you the functioning of different elements. Okay, so the major functions of the product, if you look at, I mean, the main function is to cook the rice, and to achieve that one, you need to have many functions in the product. So one is basically it should be able to contain rice and water. So you should be able to have the rice and water inside the product, that is containing the elements, the materials, rice and water, and then it has to generate heat. And at the same time, you need to have the control of heating also, so that it won't be overcooked or it won't get burnt. So that's why you need to have a control of heating. So these are the main three sub-functions we can say. and then you need to see how these sub-functions are achieved through the different elements in the product. So, you will be able to see, say, a generic diagram need not be the same as in the product that you are using, but generally there will be a heating element, there will be a circuitry which actually measures the temperature through a sensor, and then using this data used for cutting off the power supply or to stop the heating process. So, that is basically what is there in the product. Okay. So, the procedure is the first four are the almost, sorry, this technical questioning and mission statement is not necessary. So, you will be not be doing the technical questioning and mission statement in this case, but what you will be doing here is the like dislike method. Method of need identification. So, you need to identify the needs of this product. Suppose you are going to redesign this product. If you are going to redesign this product or you find that there is some problem with this product, how will you identify the needs of the customer for this product? So, that is basically the need identification. So, you use the like dislike method of need identification. The like dislike formats are available. So, use this format and identify all the needs, and then use the affinity diagram method to sort out the needs and then get the needs list as an outcome. So, you need to prepare the needs list. So, the report should contain the needs list apart from the other details asked for in the report. I hope you understood this. So, the report format, the first part will be the same as in the previous case, all the previous cases, but the difference will be the after the assembly chart, you need to have a need identification by like dislike method. So, you need to show the format you use for like dislike method of need identification, and then getting all the interpreted needs, and then how the interpreted needs are sorted out to get the top needs of the product, and then provide a needs list. So, once you prepare the needs list, your exercise is complete. Okay, so, the TA will help you to look at the product and the product's technical details, and after that you need to, as a group, you need to look at the product and then find out what kind of needs will be there for a customer, and then how do you sort out the customer needs and then get the needs list. I hope you understood this. You can go to the TA, and then TA will help you too with the experiment.
Do you know the concept of bimetallic strip, thermocouple, thermopile? So, there are two metallic strips of different melting points. So, when the melting point is reached by one, the other doesn't actually reach the melting point, and there is a bending of one strip while the other expands. So, have you come across thermostat? So, it also follows the same concept of a thermocouple and a thermopile. Okay. So, we are going to look into two products today, both working on similar principle, but the sensor is going to be different. Here we are going to use something called as a ferrite thermostat, and here we will be having the bimetallic strip. But both of them work on the same principle, that detection of heat, the current which is going to pass through the coil. So, we will start dissecting the electric cooker today. So, let's start with the parts. So, this is the metal lid, and we have the next part which is our hot pan, and it has a sieve. So, the metal pan is anodized so that there is an equal distribution of heat. And why do we have the sieve? Just to avoid the rice getting stuck or to the base of the pan. And also you have seen, like, to separate water from the actual rice. You need not only cook rice with your automatic cooker, right? It also can cook your normal vegetables. So, what is the process of rice cooking? So, there's this four steps of cooking rice. Let's take, you're going to add water, rice, there's going to be an increase in the temperature, rice absorbs water and gets cooked, correct? So, there's no water inside the pan now. What happens? Will the temperature remain the same? Why does it get burned? Correct. Why does it get burned? Don't you feel there's an increase in the temperature? Than the actual, okay, what is the boiling point of water? So, you have to choose a sensor which works perfectly for higher altitudes, at sea level and below sea level. Understood? So let's look into the other parts also. If you're able to see, so coil is actually inside. This is your heating base. Now let us dissect. Keep the screws safely. It's your base of the pan and it has all the ratings of this electric cooker. So by ratings, what do I mean here exactly? Voltage ratings, power. So if you see closely, there's a 230 volts and a 50 hertz rating. What does that mean to you? So is it the same when you go to US? If you're going to make or develop a product which is going to be of 230 volts, 50 hertz and use the same abroad, will that work? What do you need? You need an adapter. So the point is you should be able to understand the standards and where you're going to apply the product. Okay. So the next that we will be looking at is the power cord. Okay. So the power cord, what actually is happening is you're connecting to the power. It is being connected to the heating coil that we spoke about. We will be dissecting it and removing it out. So for now, you are able to see that it is connected to the heating coil. Also, you are able to see a limiting switch. So this will be placed here, which is going to be attached to the switch, your on and off switch. There is basically a lever mechanism. Once you switch this on, it is connected to the thermostat which is inside and the heating begins. Once the heating comes to a point above 100 degrees centigrade, assume, it's the metal lever which is in the thermostat, it's going to release, and this push button that we have switched on will also release. As a result, power is cut off. Do you follow? We need not set the temperature. The temperature is, yes, not the surroundings. The thermostat, so the one portion that you see here, yes, it is going to be based on the material of the thermostat. This is called as, what we use here is a ferrite thermostat. I will be telling in deep about you. So about this, can we? So this is your power cord with two wires connecting to the heating coil and one to the limiting switch. Okay, you see, this is your heating base and this is the thermostat. So if you're able to see, there's a metal lever to the thermostat. This is where you're going to connect the power cord, your nichrome wire. It is anodized so that there's an equal distribution of heat. Now this is for spreading of heat also, right? So here is where the actual heating up starts and it's going to spread throughout. Here is where you feel the heat. So let's also remove this thermostat. So the working principle of this ferrite thermostat, I'm going to explain. If you're able to see, there's a metal lever here. The metal lever gets attached. There's a magnet inside it. Okay. So here is the actual magnet and this is the metal lever. What happens is, once I'm going to switch this on, it tries to push it down and the metal lever which is attached to this end attaches to the magnet. Have you heard about paramagnetism? So a normal material at Curie point will transform into a paramagnetic metal, correct? So at 100 degrees centigrade, this metal lever becomes paramagnetic, detaches itself from the magnet and tries to push it off, which means it is trying to cut the contact from power. Understood? That's the working of our ferrite thermostat. Let's dissect this also. The advantage here is the complete lever mechanism, which is going to automatically switch it off. So if you come up with another method, another thermostat or another sensor which is going to do this using another mechanism, not probably the lever mechanism. So whichever is less costly, it has to be cost effective first, correct? And also it has to abide by the 100 degree centigrade material. You're able to follow? It's inside. So basically this metal lever, which is the switch here, this on off switch, it's being connected to this end of the metal lever. So once you switch it on, it's get attached. Everything is in contact with the power supply, correct? So what happens is 100 degree centigrade is reached, the curie point of the metal lever is reached, it behaves like a paramagnetic metal and it detaches itself. As a result, there's a switch off and a cut off from. All of this is also part of the thermostat. So I want this as a separate subsystem or a sub assembly. So let's now remove the other. So you're on and off, and we have an indicator LED which will be placed, and the other end, these two ends will be connected to power. This is ground. There's an indication of cooking. Is there an LED involved? Is there a light involved? So what? Okay. So this is your switch metal lever. You're on and off. Okay, this is a fulcrum. And then you have a simple color coded strip to show whether for indicating whether it is cooking mode or non-cooking mode. So what other modes can you think of in a automatic cooker? What other modes would you want? This just provides you with, okay, warming the food. Anything else? So you have only one pan here. How would you add compartments? Can someone tell me the working of this electric cooker? Working principle.
So we press this lever. The lever then locks the ferret thermostat into on position, which then clicks to the magnet, hence completing the circuit. Now the current passes through the heating coil. Because of its resistance, it builds up heat. Then this heat is transferred to the heating pad and thereby increasing the temperature in the water or the cooking substance. When it becomes sufficiently heated, then the magnet or the lever that we locked into the magnet, it will become paramagnetic and it detaches from
the
100 degree curie point. Yeah. When it reaches the curie point of the material, then it becomes paramagnetic and hence the current gets disconnected.
The lever
gets disconnected and then switch off.
You're able to see in this metal lid, there's a hole. You're able to observe. So have you seen a pressure cooker? How do you compare this pressure cooker and our electric cooker?
Even if there is a blockage, that is why we are providing an extra spacing on the sides to prevent pressure buildup. No, that is what. See, there's side holes and there's an opening here. Despite this, if there's a pressure blockage, we are providing means to just, these are all safety concerns.
The complete water gets absorbed. So once the complete water gets absorbed is when your actual temperature rises. Correct? So if you're going to add excess water, then there's a problem. There are specific measures as to how much rice and how much water should be added for an automatic cooker, which is different from that of a pressure cooker, different from that of a normal cooking. So moving on to the next product, this is our electric kettle. I wouldn't mention it water kettle. What else can we do with this?
Boil water.
Store water. So do you guys not cook anything with the kettle? So if you're able to actually see, the coil inside is open here. Can you cook Maggi in this?
No.
Can you cook Maggi in this? So what happens when the coil, heating coil is in direct contact with water and it is being at a surface below? So this is your support bracket for the switch. Here is the actual switch on and off that we do. It is connected to a lever again. And here, if you're able to see, we have a coil, this is the one socket, the support brace, which connects to the power base. So once the jar sits on the power base, it comes in contact with the power cord and automatically heating begins. What is the principle of the heating that we are using here?
This is
the support brace. Here we have the switch. We will be able to remove the switch also. So this is the switch. Okay. And we have a light indicator which will be present below the switch. The switch is connected to the lever. Goes up or down and it is connected to this point. The other end of this lever is connected to your, yes. So we have, this is a bimetallic strip. Okay. So this bimetallic strip is placed exactly beneath this smoke tube or the not smoke, vapor chamber, steam tube. So once water starts heating, the steam gets into the steam tube and this bimetallic strip, which is placed in direct contact with the steam tube, is going to be heated up. Once heating is detected, the strip melts. And if you're able to watch, okay, so we are switching it on
once the heating or the steam comes in contact with the bimetallic strip, what happens is it melts and it opens. So once this switch is opened, again the same concept, power is cut off and you cannot heat it up until some period. Have you noticed that? So exactly, you have to think like that. So where can you compensate for all these components? There was a separate LED indicator to show whether it is connected to power or not. If there is problem. So but the point is for you to just have the heating. So this is the washer. No, not from here, from the water. If it is not properly grounded and if there's current passage through this heating coil. Yeah, that's the design. There are two designs, one with direct contact, one. So what do you think? So here if you see, the heating coil is being connected to this washer, separates water which is on this side, and here it is going to be connected to the power cord. It will be sitting like this. So basically it sits like this. Without your water kettle, if you see, this is the actual structure. No. So if you're able to cover this up and provide a passage for heat to actually go into this water flask, what would it be? What kind of designs you would come up with? Metal base? Shouldn't it pass the heat as and how much it gets? So if it is in direct contact. Okay, so washer is the problem. So one thing that you're suggesting is provide a better washer size, and the other one is to completely lock it off from water. Correct? So why do we have such a complicated design for the heat and coil? Okay. So how would you change the mechanism? So that comes in direct contact with this heating coil. This is for steam. This comes in contact with your heating coil, which is placed here. If it is open, if your lid is open, then the steam will not enter directly here. This has to act. Okay, so I want to ask a question. Why this model of a heating coil? Why can't it just be a plain circular, more area of contact? So if you're going to I just have a question. So if you're going to place resistors in series and resistors in parallel, which would provide more heat? More heat. What's the equation in terms of V? Because here your I varies, V is constant. So your parallel connection has better heating than your series connection. Fine. So if you're going to alter the heating coil design, what better can you suggest? So if you see, it's like protruding. If you're going to place it inside a compartment, should it be like this or you need some other model? Okay, so you have to increase the number of coils probably. Spiral. Mesh. So if you are having a mesh, and it, you should also understand that it is going to heat. Will it be able to hold that much of heat? Okay, so think about the designs. It can be a coil. Yes. You didn't see any facility for it to expand, right? It was just a washer. So probably you could think of this. If it is going to expand, what would happen?
It could break.
Exactly. So but do you need that much of heating to happen? Can't you go in for a metal which is going to accommodate all of this, because we are just going to heat water. You're thinking of, okay, so so it goes in with your usage also, correct? I'm not able to get you, sorry. Can you name? This is Usha. Yes, the model name is given here. This is EK2612. So we will also open up this. Can you open it up? So open this up. Okay. Yes, it will be sitting over the heat base. So it is supposed to come in contact. This whatever protrusions that you are able to see here will come in contact with the power cord. So we will open that. Can you open it? So you can see the bimetallic strip. Yes, it is supposed to detect. So it basically depends upon the material of your bimetallic strip. So your sensor has to be effective enough to detect the change in temperature. No, not small amount of heat. That's what. So it has to be with a melting point, I mean boiling point of water. So yeah, the washer will go in the separation space. Let's place it like this. Okay. Comes in and then you place. So you will be placing these. So this is the complete setup. And here. Switch will, I mean, your LED indicator will be placed here and the switch comes in. This is your filter. And you can see the steam tubule here. It is an open, the coil is open, right? So that's open. So if you see, this is the power cord, your two plus and minus and your ground. So what? Okay. You're able to see. So when you place your fan on top of this, automatically this will open up and it gets exposed to the curve. And this is just a simple spring mechanism. So you should be able to appreciate the little designs that they have put in. Okay, so instead, this is not powered. Okay, if what if it is not closed?
Anyone could touch it while it's on.
It, you can touch it even when it is not on. Yes, you can. See, no, it's not all the time that adults use it, right? So what if children are there? No, this is not a switch. This is just a power cord which is going to be connected. And once you connect it to your actual seating base, it will provide power. The switch is different. Here is your actual switch. This. So have you taken enough pictures? Yes. So that should be one of your design improvements. So when you place it in a different compartment and you place it in direct contact with water, the design is going to change. And whatever the mechanisms involved in this direct contact of a water kettle is going to be different from that of a non-contact water kettle. Okay? That is how the current water kettles. Have you seen another version of this water kettle?
No.
Not this one. Yes, new one. So it will be open and you just have to place it on top. So there the opening or closing, whatever comes in, it will come along with the coil. Instead of placing the coil with the... Here, it cuts off at 100. Once it starts boiling, it cuts off. So if you want to keep it warm, you have to add another... So have you heard of fuzzy logic concepts? Fuzzy logic. So can you incorporate any of your warm mode, hot mode? Can you explain? Okay, so it's basically like a condition wherein you assign a parameter to a set of values. It need not be either 0 or 1. It can take any value between 0 and 1 and you can assign a state to it. Okay, so if in case you take 0 to be your off mode, 1 to be your full, say cooked mode, in between is your warm mode. So you can incorporate any number of logics into this and create your other modes without actually incorporating another mechanical point of view. Despite that, you can just add in logics and create a separate circuitry to provide the heat that you actually want. So what if you reduce the amount of current that is actually passing through? Yes, you should. Yes. Okay, so start assembling the product. Any questions? Yes. Whichever is in direct contact has more heating than the top layer. So if you want to make it, we have a question, guys. If you want to provide equal heating like throughout the water which is present in the can. What else can happen? So if you're going to change the design so as to and exactly if you're going to change the container metal to an anodized one so that it provides even distribution of heat instead of going for a vertical heating or no that's base okay this is basic. Anodized is for just providing equal amount of heat, so or equal distribution. See, it's you're going to coat something. The coating that you're doing is a material. Yes, it's a material which provides even distribution. That's it. Yes. No, this is a model. This is a model. It will be. So what you see here is an anodized pan. This is an anodized pan. The rest of the material is just a metal. This is basically your C1. It's two. Below, bottom. Okay, assembled. Any questions on this product? So for the design improvements, what and all have we discussed? Direct contact of the heating coil. Other one was material. So we can go in for a metal. If you go in for a metal, would it cost more, less? It costs more. So that is also a factor. Third, we talked about even distribution of heat. So if the coil is going to be vertical or coating of the entire inner layer, so one other thing that we spoke of was to store the water and keep it in warm mode. Correct? So any other additions that you want to make to? Moisture. Washer. Open. Open and fix. So support bracket. Button. இது மட்டும்தானா we are fixing back the support bracket okay. And here we will be placing this entire thing so your product actually consists of your water can it also has a indicator for how much of water it shouldn't go above this value so what is the capacity of this so what happens if you can if you go above this limit
the water is not leaking
spillage okay so they would have the whole point of equal heating doesn't happen. It actually goes one layer to one layer, right? So this is the maximum limit of 1.0 liters. Yes, coil below. One is there is no direct contact, and you are trying to place the heating coil below, that is actual, and also the consumption of heat from the coil happens from below. They are not trying to replace this whole heating coil problem. They are just trying to place it not in contact. So there is less, no. Uniform heating happens only with a material which is going to be completely anodized. So if you go in for a steel water kettle, okay. Any questions?
Is it for this?
It's not so good. No, this is just an add-on to it. No specific. Is there a compartment? You want it open? Fine. Okay, so shall we go in for the discussion? So for this lab we saw two products. One is the automatic cooker, automatic electric cooker, and the other one is your automatic electric kettle or your electric kettle. You can also so here this product is going to be just a cooking mode and an off mode, same way as this electric kettle, which has direct contact of the heating coil. It's going to switch on, and once the water is boiled, it's going to switch off. These two is what we looked at today. Thank you.